I like the way Mike holds the camera covering up the red light as if to say, like, you know, no, no, honestly, guys, I'm not recording this. No.
Welcome to the GCN show.
Matt, we start the show, mate. Go on, Ty.
Thanks, mate, thanks. Welcome to the GCN show. This week we've got cyclocross, both pro and amateur. We've got a new world hour record. We've got team news, tech news, caption tweet, and comment of the week.
It's not really retro tech this week, more just retro.
Last week, Matthias Brändle set a brand new world hour record of 51.852 kilometres, beating Jens Voigt's marker of 51.115, which he'd set just 42 days previously. The young Austrian did his record at the UCI headquarters in Aeg, Switzerland, on a 200 metre track.
Interesting to know what his average speed was for the hour.
Yeah, has anyone calculated the average speed?
Well, we know the time and maybe the speed. I mean, we'll get back to you, but I think it's ballpark 51 k's an hour. Arguably the most prestigious award in cycling, after of course the GCN Awards, is the Velo D'Or, awarded by the French cycling magazine Velo. Now for the fourth time, Alberto Contador has won the award despite crashing out of the Tour de France. Now Berti this year won Tirreno Adriatico, Tour of the Basque Country, as well as the Vuelta Espana, and then rounded out the season by finishing second in the World Tour. Now, I did give Berti a quick call on his mobile. Hello, yeah. Just to pass on my congratulations to him. And he did text me, actually. I'm not too sure exactly what it means, but he said, "Por favor, mi deja solo." Thanks very much for that, Berti. Catch up soon.
One of the great things about the UCI easing the bike restrictions for the hour record, other than the fact that people are now actually doing the hour record, is the tech. So 42 days ago, Trek put their best foot forward and gave us the speed concept. And now we have Scott's Plasma 5. Now, like Voigt, Brändle went with double discs, which is a bit like double denim, but even harder to pull off. And unlike Voigt, he went one gear harder. He was riding 55.13 to Voigt's 55.14. So it's no wonder he went faster.
Yep, so now the burning question. Given that there was only 700 metres difference between the two records, how much of that was down to the rider and how much of it was down to the bike? Last week's caption photo was this one of myself, Matt and Sai doing a genuine sprint finish. And the winner is Rifki Ramputra with this. Aerodynamic wheels versus aerodynamic under helmets.
I'd laugh at that.
Congratulations, Rifki. Get in touch and we will send you a GCN hat. Now for this week's caption competition, we've got a photo from actually back in Amstel Gold in April.
I'll get you started. Omega Pharma Quick Step hedged their bets. The Amstel Gold Race. Sorry.
Hopefully some of you could do a bit better than that, and then you might win a hat. Just.
Cervélo are to partner with Velocio Sports, the organisation behind the highly successful Lululemon team. Now, Cervélo will provide all of the backup for the team next year, and over the next few weeks, we'll find out exactly what the team roster is and who the two additional sponsors are going to be. Cervélo have previously supported women's cycling with Cervélo Test Team between 2008 and 2010, and Garmin Cervélo in 2011. And it's good to have them back.
On to team news now, and we've been hearing rumours for months about a new squad, either a development feeder type squad for Team Sky or possibly just a squad on its own built around current world time trial champion Bradley Wiggins. Basically, the idea behind it appears to be trying to get the British track squad riders together doing a road programme as they build up for the Olympics in Rio in 2016.
But it's hard to envisage Wiggins himself ending up there in 2015, given that he's already stated that one of his aims for next season is Paris-Roubaix, and therefore he'll need to be riding for Team Sky or another World Tour team to do that.
Right, time for GCN Strava Club now, and we're finally closing in on 10,000 members, so make sure that you get your riding mates signed up. Jarkko Haikaranta has once again been bossing it in terms of distance ridden, but it was Erik Nieuwsholm who did the longest individual ride. He won the Flow Rider race across America, starting off at 7 a.m. in the morning and finishing at 2:30 a.m. the following day. An average speed of quite an impressive 30 k's per hour.
And Pham Dang Son tops the climbers leaderboard, although despite putting in some solid hours, we wonder whether some of the elevation stats are a little bit dodgy. So we'll also give a mention to Steinar Rasmussen, because he racked up 19,842 metres of climbing, which is pretty impressive.
Now, it's been a while since we picked out a member for a special mention, but we've done so this week, and we've chosen Laurie Rummelhart, who's been doing loads of riding around the San Francisco area, averaging 9 rides per week for the last 4 weeks, but last week she did 12, totalling 307.7 kilometres. Well done.
Yeah, and if you think you know someone who deserves a special mention, then just let us know in the comments section, and we'll go through, check out what they're up to, and maybe give them a bit of sofa love. Your sofa love, right?
Yeah, I'd happily give some sofa love. Bring it on. Dug deep into our cycling cave and found these rather gorgeous pair of cycling shoes. These are made by Sidi, the company founded back in 1960, and these are all leather cycling shoes. Now, these were the weapons of choice years and years before full carbon soles. These were, of course, designed for toe clips and straps, the first sort of pedal assistant I ever used, way before using clipless pedals. Crying out loud. Now, the way they were fitted to the pedals was by these little cleats at the bottom. These are actually screwed in with an Allen key setting, but years before this sort of shoe was made, you actually nailed the cleat to the bottom of the shoe. But to be honest, the most remarkable thing about these shoes, aside from their comfort and their aesthetic appeal, is the fact that the sole was made completely of leather, layers of leather, which they are quite stiff, but nowhere near the stiffness of soles that you find today. As you can see, they do bend. They're a classic shoe, without a shadow of a doubt. I've got some very, very fun memories. Although not this exact pair, this is the shoe that I first used when I got onto a bike back in 1984.
Last weekend's cyclocross was absolutely classic. The legendary Koppenberg cross on the Saturday, followed by the spectacular sandpit in Zonnewen on the Sunday.
The Koppenberg cross came, oh, f***ing sorry.
Sorry about that.
I can't believe they haven't learned their lines again this week.
The Koppenberg cross came down to a sprint finish between the master of the discipline Sven Nys and the apprentice 20-year-old Wout Van Aert. Surprisingly, it was Van Aert who took the win, but Nys was far from happy about it. Coming in towards the final corner, they were just about to lap Van Aert's teammate, who seemed reluctant to get out of the way. Kevin Powers, meanwhile, came in third place. No such controversy in the women's race, with Sophie De Boer comfortably winning by 18 seconds.
And in Sunday's Super Prestige in Zonnewen, Sven Nys was once again pipped into second place, this time by Kevin Powers. The race was absolutely enthralling to watch, coming right down to the wire. For many, it looked as if it was Sven Nys' race to win. He gapped Kevin Powers several times in the last lap, but seemed to lack just that final bit of punch to make it stick. And ultimately, Kevin Powers timed it perfectly, coming back to Nys just within sight of the finish line and then out sprinting him. In the women's race, Belgian national champion Sanne Kant showed that she could, showing excellent technical skills in the sand and beating Nikki Harris and Ellen Van Looy.
I see what you did there, I think, with that Kant and... Good.
It was a joke. I made a joke. Matt didn't laugh though.
It's just not funny.
This week's Club of the Week comes from the UK and was sent in by Minnie Messi, who says Otley Cycle Club is the best club. We're a big club of over 250 members. We're a smart blue jersey with Chevin Cycles Bike Shop as the sponsor. We have many club runs with rides for every age and ability. You'll be all right, Matt. Including all-day Sunday rides for slower, you'll be all right, Matt, and faster, oh, you'll be all right, Si, riders, and Saturday morning rides for children of any age, ranging from averages of 10 to 17 miles per hour on a hilly but enjoyable route. We also race at the local Gastric League.
Grass track.
Gastric League. What? Gastric League.
Women's racing received a welcome boost again last week with the announcement that the US Pro Challenge will run a multiple day women's event alongside the men's in 2050.
Now, details are still quite light, but it looks like the women's race will take in many of the current roads that are being used in the men's event. And another race in the calendar, it's great to see. Comment of the week now, and this one from Bike and Dog Trips really caught our attention actually. I understand you have problems with clipless perverts, Matt.
Oh, soddy.
Now, fortunately, Bike and Dog Trips took to the comments section again just 2 hours later to confirm that actually they meant pedals and that it was down to the phone autocorrect. But do you have problems with clipless perverts, Matt?
No, this is what a real clipless pervert looks like.
Genuinely though, this was a great comment which we received underneath our Off The Back video last Sunday. It's from Michael Parkinson, who said, "Favorite video is the Matt Stevens top 10 ways to lose weight. It inspired me to buy a cheap racer for starting road cycling. I changed my eating habits and dropped from 14.5 to 12 stone in 6 months, and I'm now doing 80 plus miles sport eat on a carbon bike. Big thanks to Matt."
Nice work, Michael, as well. That's great stuff. Yeah. Coming up on the channel this week, on Monday, we've got how to set up your cyclocross bike. On Tuesday, of course.
Hello, and welcome to the GCN show.
On Wednesday, another cyclocross video, how to corner. And on Thursday, we're going to give you our top 10 ways to make indoor training more bearable.
Friday, it's our latest training video. Saturday, it's Meet the Presenter with Simon Richardson. And on Sunday, it's deep, 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 deep down in the GCN vaults. Not a lot of transfer news this week, but Jani Brakovic, the former winner of the Dauphiné, moves across to the American Pro Continental Team United Healthcare from Astana. And Lachlan Morton moves to the Continental Team Jelly Belly after spending a couple of years with Garmin Sharp.
Our tweet of the week this time comes in the form of a picture which was doing the rounds on Sunday night. Now, the original source, though, was a picture from Christopher Job, the German photographer, and it's of the crowds, the incredible crowds at Zonovan Cross Race on Sunday.
We're actually expecting similar scenes, you know, for Matt's first cross race.
I thought we were expecting more than that, not similar.
Yeah, probably, actually.
Oh, you found me. Shh. As you can see, I'm here on the latest cyclocross shoot. It's absolutely fantastic. I've only laid it down once so far. I'm absolutely covered in mud, loving it. But that Cy Richardson is such a slave driver. Threshold this, threshold that. I just need a couple of minutes to myself to...
Yeah, I kind of laid it down there. Sorry about that.
Once again, we're going to leave you with Extreme Corner. Something slightly different this week involving a unicycle. Enjoy.
That is genuinely impressive, actually. I never knew that they use clipless pedals on unicycles.
I think they were flat pedals, mate. I don't think those were clipless.
They can't have been, mate. You see the size of that bunny hop? Crikey, this is new.
It's right, isn't it? Hmm. Anyway, if you would like to keep up to date with Matt Stevens' cyclocross endeavours, you can click over here.
And if you're looking forward to Friday's training video, make sure you check out our old ones over there. And if you just want to become a fan of GCN, and Dan must have at least one or two, then click on us.
Two.
You've got two fans.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.